Hey, welcome to another episode of Eric's Camping Adventures. Today I'm headed out to western Oklahoma to Romannose State Park. Romannose State Park is situated in the middle of ranch land, and it's a canyon, and there is a Civilian Conservation Corps lake that was built. In fact, right now they may still be working on the dam, and there may not be any water in the lake, but there's still lots of hiking trails and canyons to explore. The state park is named for Chief Henry Romannose, who is quite a colorful figure. He initially was a warrior for the Cheyenne tribe in the Red River War, and he was imprisoned after the war for some time in Virginia. And then he went to Hampton College after he was released and came back to Oklahoma and became very influential in seeking the education of Native Americans. So I have been to Romannose State Park in the past. It was probably maybe 8 years ago, and I was there with my wife and kids in April, and it started out to be a warm afternoon, and by evening it had turned cold, and it started sleeting, and it turned to freezing rain, and it went down to 20 degrees, and while we were able to stay warm through the night, it was pretty crazy watching it turn from a calm, warm, sunny afternoon into this crazy sleet storm. And my kids were scarred by that experience. And I think I was scarred because they were scarred. But I still want to go back and see the park, and come along with me. I pulled into Muffler Gap, where I had reserved Site 49 right on the shores of Beekler Lake, and began to immediately set up my shelter, just like I always do.
may wonder in my videos why sometimes I have a cooking portion and other times I don't. Truth is I look for good roadkill on the way to my campsite, and if I find some good roadkill and it's still light out, I feel like I can assess whether or not the roadkill is fresh and whether or not I've got good meat that I can eat for dinner. Usually the size of the maggots will tell you how old the meat is and whether it's badly infected yet. Some people are better at this than I am, but I feel like I have to assess the meat in the daylight. I am just not good at checking out the meat once it's dark. So I always try to get to my campsite with a fresh piece of meat during the daylight. Okay, I was just kidding you about the roadkill. That is some pre-cooked chicken. My wife pre-cooked it for me. She was afraid for me to actually cook it at my campsite. She thought that I might undercook it and end up sick at my campsite by myself. I am not a cook. So I put what was left over in a Tupperware container, put it back in my fridge, and I had myself a nice dinner of some baked chicken, some gnocchi with cheese, and some broccoli that had been warmed and cooked right on the cast iron. After setting up my shelter and getting some good food in me, I got my drone out to do a little bit of playing and just took a look around the lake and around the park. You can see that the second lake is still drained as they're working on the dam and making some repairs. On these hills back behind and throughout the canyon behind the hills are lots of hiking trails. This is what a sunset looks like when there is so much wind kicking up the dust. The sky is clear, but the light is indistinct from the sun. This is the Lodge and the Foggy Bottom Restaurant on Romannose State Park. Beyond that is the golf course. And you wouldn't believe it. You can be very sophisticated and stay here, but there are also backcountry campsites down below the dam. Well, it is getting late out here in western Oklahoma. It's been a beautiful day. It's been sunshiny and up to 74 degrees. And that's just hard to complain about in the middle of the winter. It's just the very beginning of March. And this has been a very pleasant day. And I think it's going to be like that the next couple days. It's going to be windy, but we can handle that as long as it's warm. I'm going to turn in and I'll see you in the morning. all good things must end.
Headed home after two nights at romannosestatepark, and you can tell from my puffy jacket and my wool hat that it turned cool. It was about 29 last night, and no sunshine this morning and lots of wind, so it makes it feel a whole lot colder. In fact, late last night there was a couple came in and occupied the campsite next to me, and they must have looked at the old forecast because they came in t-shirts and ended up sleeping inside their car, and I saw all the condensation on the inside of their windows, and I chuckled to myself and I thought, I've done that before. Out in western Oklahoma, there are just a few things that really come to the surface as you make a drive down one of the main roads, and that is oil, horse farms, and then cattle ranching. And that is the lifeblood of western Oklahoma. Well, I'm glad you joined me for another episode of Eric's Camping Adventures. Next week, come back and I'm going to show you some of the things I explored at romannosestatepark, including a hike to Inspiration Point and then some exploring around on my mountain bike just around the park up to a natural spring. Come back.